Hello and welcome to Remove Duplicates in Excel. My name's Jeff, I'm glad you're here. Let's just jump right in. In this short video, we're gonna talk about a few different options for removing duplicate values from your worksheets. Let's just open Excel, exercise one. All right, in this first exercise, we're just gonna get warmed up with a single column of data. So basically we have these items. So one option is to simply select any cell within that range and head to Data, Remove Duplicates. Now, we see the Remove Duplicates dialog, and it's asking us to confirm a few different things. Now, in this case, there's only a single column, so all we really need to confirm is, does our data have a header row? And we'll get to this columns list box in the next exercise, but for now, our data does have headers, so we simply click OK. And what happens is we get a dialog that confirms 4 duplicates were found and removed, 5 unique values remain. So we can simply click OK. If a value had multiple rows, it removed any of the additional rows, leaving the first row. And now the question is, okay, Jeff, fine, I can remove them, but what if I wanted to, like, identify potential duplicates instead of just like removing them? Okay, for that we would use conditional formatting. So what we do is we select our range of cells, we go to home, we go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and duplicate values. And here we have a couple of options. We can highlight the duplicates or uniques. Here we're gonna go ahead and highlight the duplicates and we can select a different formatting. Depending on what you're working on, feel free to check out those options. And then we click OK. And what this is doing is it's saying, these are the items that I found more than once in this list. So if you just wanna identify duplicates, check out conditional formatting. And if you wanna actually remove the duplicates, then that's when we'd use the remove duplicates command instead. Cool, all right, now let's make it more interesting by looking at multiple columns. Exercise 2. Okay, in this exercise, we have multiple columns, and the key element here is to define which columns have to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. So let's think about that for a second. Are these 3 rows duplicates? Well, I don't know. It depends on what you're working on as to how you define a duplicate. Is it just that the items have to match? If so, then yeah, these would be considered duplicates. Or it might be that the item and amount values have to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. So this really just depends on what you're working on. So my goal is to show you how to actually tell Excel which columns have to match to be considered a duplicate. And we do that inside the Remove Duplicates dialog. So let's just select any cell within the range, Data, Remove Duplicates. Here we see that our data has a header row, so that's fine. And now we get this columns list box. And this is how we tell Excel which columns have to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. If I were to check item only, then it means if the item matches, that row is considered a duplicate, and to remove any subsequent rows. If, however, I check item and amount, then it means both of those values have to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. Again, there's no right answer. It really just depends on what you're working on. So we'll just do them both. First of all, if item matches, we click OK. And now you can see 3 duplicate values were found and removed. So we click OK. So we are left with only 1 CG231 row. Let me go ahead and undo. And now let's try it again. Data, remove duplicates. This time, I'm going to say that item and amount both have to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. When I click OK, now I have 2 duplicates values found and removed. I click OK, and now I have 2 CG231 rows. Okay, so that's how we can communicate with Excel which columns have to match to be considered a duplicate. Let's go to the next exercise. Exercise 3. Now in this exercise, we're gonna take a look at the unique function, which is an alternative to the remove duplicates command. Depending on your version of Excel, you may or may not have access to this function. The easiest way to find out if you do is to type equals UNI, and if you get unique in that dropdown, then it means your version of Excel has unique. Now, what does the unique function do? It basically says, I'm gonna look at an array, that's just a range, I'm gonna look at this range, and I'm gonna return 1 unique row for each unique value. So for example, let's say I wanted to return 1 row for every unique item. I could simply use that range in the unique function and hit enter, and the unique function looks at that range and returns 1 row for every unique value. But what if I wanted to consider multiple columns? The unique function handles that too. Equals unique. We can just use this entire range here. Close function and enter. And now we see that we have 2 CG231 rows as expected. Now let's go take a look at this function for a second. The first argument is the array, and that's the only required argument, but there are 2 additional arguments. The next one is by call, so that just means are we looking at rows or columns? But then the next one is exactly once. And what this means is, do I want to return the values that appear one and only one time. In other words, I'm not trying to remove any additional duplicates. I only want that returned if it appears only once. So depending on what you're working on, this could come in handy. So if we set that to true and hit enter, now we see that we get CG231 with 135 because this appears only once. It's not giving me CG231605 because that has a duplicate. Okay, so depending on what you're working on, you may want to experiment with that argument as well. All right, let's go to the next exercise, exercise 4. All right, another way to do this is with Power Query. So here we can select any range in our table, head to data and say from table range. And once again, we are left with this idea of how are we defining a duplicate? In other words, does one column have to match for it to be considered a duplicate? Do both columns have to match for it to be considered a duplicate? So this is very similar to the remove duplicates command. In Power Query, the way that we communicate this to Excel is by which columns we select. So if I select item and only item, then when I do the remove duplicates, it's going to look at that item column only. So for example, when I do remove rows, remove duplicates, it's going to give me one row for CG231. Okay, now let me go ahead and undo that. And now let's say I wanted both the item and amount columns to match for that row to be considered a duplicate. In that case, I would select item and then I would hold down shift or control and I would select any additional columns. In this case, it's the amount column. Now when I do remove rows, remove duplicates, both of those columns have to match for it to be considered a duplicate row. And as we can see, we have two CG231 rows as expected. Now I can simply close and load two. I can send this back to a table in an existing worksheet and I can go right here and click OK. And now we've got it. Cool. All right. So those are a few different ways to remove duplicates. We have the remove duplicates command. We looked at single column versus multiple columns. We looked at the unique function and then we also looked at Power Query. Hey, hopefully these things helped. Thanks so much for joining me. Have a great day. Hey, Excel user. If you ever need to create summary reports, check out my pivot table for beginners video. It starts at the beginning and shows how to store the data transactions in a table and then how to summarize those transactions with a pivot table report. I hope it helps unlock the incredible power of pivot tables.
This video is a production of Excel University.